makes daily life smooth and stress-free. It really does. Good habits are good. Examples for your dog, depending on what you want, what you need, and what is good for your dog. Some of you know how it works, because the first thing you do when you get a puppy is to teach him to sit and get a treat. So he starts to sit every time there's food around. Right? Some dogs do that. It becomes a habit, so every time there's a food somewhere, they sit. That became a habit. And that's a bad habit, of course, but still a habit. You can do the same thing with good habits. You should, for instance, make a habit of use a harness. You should make a habit of letting the dog have choices whenever possible. You should have a habit of letting dogs explore. That's hard for some people, because I don't want the dog to go here, go there, and do something I haven't told them to do. It can be having treat search for dogs. You can teach the dog to stay in the car and get comfortable with that. That's necessary. Instead of having a dog who cannot stay alone in the car, you can teach him the habit of being in the car and be okay with it. Understanding the hand signal, be calm in meeting situations with people, walk nicely on the leash, curvy when meeting, accept handling, accept being groomed and clipping nails and brushing teeth and whatever you do. Yes, you can make that a habit as well. My dog does not like to have his nails clipped. Absolutely not. But it's a habit, so when I come with the scissors, he just stands there suffering. No protesting, just lifting the ball. Okay, love. Poor me. But it's a habit, so we do it because it's necessary. Brushing teeth the same.